how much is too much in a combat sports fight? Where is the line between, hey, the blood, the guts, the punishment, it's all part of the game. It comes with the territory, and this is too violent. This is too gory. They really need to stop this fight. Where is that line? And the bigger question is, was that line crossed in Valentina Shevchenko's brutal beatdown of Priscilla? Because it seems that there are a lot of MMA fans that feel this fight did cross that line. It was too much. It was too bloody. It was too gory. And then you still have a group of people who say, no, this all comes with the territory. These ladies are both just doing their job. So y'all know we got to talk about it. Amazing Eric Sports. Let's go, man.
Amazing Eric Sports. Sports and laughs. It's all love. Ow!
What is up, all my fellow MMA heads? You are now tuned into another episode of the Amazing Eric Sports Show, and I am your host, your homie, your dude, your man. It's your boy Eric. So let's just jump right into it. Today we have a video. We're gonna get down in the blood and the guts of the MMA today, of combat sports as a whole, actually. When is too much too much? When is the beatdown too severe? We wanna talk about Valentina Shevchenko's bloody beatdown of Priscilla. Now, I'm sure you guys have noticed that I'm just referring to her as Priscilla right now. I haven't jumped on that last name yet. And the reason I waited is because I needed to address some of my most faithful, loyal, I love them so much, some of my most caring viewers. Even if they're not my viewers, they come through the video and they care so much that you say everybody's name right. And that's very important. I've actually given you guys a name. The name of your crew is The Name Gang. You know what? I didn't say it with enough spunk. I'm gonna put a little effects on it. The name of your crew is The Name Gang. Yeah, you like that? You like how your boy hooked you up? I threw a little echo, a little reverb on your name. The Name Gang. And I love The Name Gang. Some uploaders get mad at The Name Gang. I don't get mad at The Name Gang. You actually keep me tight. I'm gonna tell you how you kept me tight. I used to call her Megan Anderson when it first started. You guys came through and said, no, it's Megan, and I needed to get that correct. I used to actually call Rose Nama Eunice Rose Nama Junis, and you guys came through and you tied me up. You only make us better because we need to say everybody's name right. But with Priscilla, the problem is everybody says the name different. The announcer calls her out and he says Colchietta. The next person says Coshueta. I was looking at Karen Bryan and Tyron Woodley. Every time they all referred to her, someone said it different. So if The Name Game will forgive me for this video, we're just gonna call her Priscilla. So let's talk about this bloody beatdown that Valentina put on Priscilla. And yes, it was bloody. You have fans that are upset. You have fighters that are upset. It seems there are a lot of people that were really bothered by this fight. And I understand everybody has a right to their own opinion, but I do think we need to start here for this conversation. I would like to say this first. Valentina Shevchenko did nothing wrong. Valentina Shevchenko did her job. I think it is unfair for us to ask these fighters to be warriors, to ask them to almost be animals, to walk into a ring, to walk into a cage and put their life on the line, and then ask them to some way be able to figure out when too much is too much. It is Valentina Shevchenko's job to seek and destroy to either the fighter submits or the referee stops it. That's her job. She did her job. And you guys know me. Those of you that know me know I go really far to try to respect everyone's opinion. So just because I'm having a hard time with the people who seem to be upset with Valentina over this, that doesn't mean you're wrong. What I'd like you to do, come into the comment section. If you're a person that feels like Valentina Shevchenko in some way was wrong for this, I would like for you to come into the comment section and just explain it to me. Tell me your point of view. Maybe you can show me something that I'm not seeing. Now, in no way do I mean that to sound like or come across like I don't care what happens to Priscilla, like I don't care how bad she's getting beat or how bad she's being hurt. No, we always want to see both fighters walk away healthy, both fighters go home to their families in one piece. I have so much respect for all these ladies, for all these men that climb through the ropes of a boxing ring or that enter that octagon through that cage and get locked in. You always want to see everybody go home safe. And that brings me to the next point. And the next point is more in the form of a question, because I'm asking you guys a question, because truthfully, I'm asking myself this question too. And that question is, are we all hypocrites? And what I mean by that is, the Valentina versus Priscilla fight is a very good example of how we can be hypocritical when it comes to combat sports. Because if we are being honest, one of the things we do like about combat sports, part of the appeal of combat sports, is the pure savagery to it. The fact that these people go in and they punch each other, they kick each other. I'm just being real. The blood, the knockouts, the violence, that's part of what us as humans enjoy about combat sports. Now, I'm a person, I really enjoy the art of the sports, both sports. I really enjoy the art of boxing. I really enjoy the art of MMA. That's why most of my favorite fighters aren't knockout artists. They're actually very skilled technical fighters. That's the kind of fighters I like, but I'm not gonna sit here and tell you that my human side doesn't like to see a good scrap, doesn't like to see somebody get punched and fall out. Let's just be real. But then these fights happen, and I find myself sitting there watching the fight, and the blood is interesting to me at first, and then all of a sudden that other human side comes out, and you're like, oh, stop it, what is he doing? Stop the fight. Did you guys feel like that? Please go into the comment section, let me know if I'm the only one who does that. It's a weird thing, right? Because we really enjoy the savagery, we really like the beatdown, and then all of a sudden the beatdown gets too brutal and another side of us comes out and we're like, whoa, wait, stop. So what does that mean? Are we just a bunch of hypocrites? I'm not saying we are. Somebody help me. Jump into the comment section. Tell me what you think and let me know, have any of you ever experienced that same thing while watching a fight? Now, this brings us to the last point of this video. And what I wanted to do was save the best for last on this one. This is the person that most people seem to have the biggest problem with in this fight. Put him up on the screen, please. There he is, Mr. Mario Yamasaki. And I find it ironic that he's doing the heart symbol before this fight, because this is what most people are questioning in him now. Do you have a heart, Mario? Where was your heart while Priscilla was being beaten senseless on that mat? And I am not at all going to try to defend Mario here, because there were plenty of times, actually in the first round, when Priscilla was kind of pinned up against the cage and Valentina was letting her have it when they were on the ground, I thought he actually could have stopped it there. So there were plenty of times that I felt Mario could have, in my opinion, should have stopped it before it got to where it got to. But I do want to make this point. Sometimes, just sometimes, referees see something from a viewpoint that we don't see it. And what I mean by that is sometimes there are outside variables that we don't necessarily see through the TV that may be having an effect on the referee's judgment or the lack of judgment that the referee might show. One thing you have to remember is that Priscilla was the hometown fighter. In this case, she was the home country fighter. She's Brazilian. She was there in front of all of her people from Brazil. When referees are in an arena and the hometown fighter is there, they can feel the energy of the crowd. They can tell how bad the crowd wants their fighter to win. And they have a tendency. He's not the first to do this. I'm going to give you an example. Holly Holm. We all know Holly Holm. A lot of us like Holly Holm. Some of us hate Holly Holm, whatever. But we all know who she is. When she was boxing in her hometown of New Mexico, she was fighting Ann Sophie Mathis. She was the hometown fighter. Everybody was there in Albuquerque to see her. It was her show. Ann Sophie Mathis begins to literally beat the stuffing out of Holly Holm. There is nothing left in Holly Holm. The referee will not stop the fight. Do you think he was not stopping the fight because he wanted Holly to get hurt? No, he was trying his hardest to give her a chance. Maybe she's gonna come back. Maybe she's gonna get a second win. Holly Holm is just a lifeless person laying around the ring getting hit until the knockout came and it was so brutal, Holly had nothing left. I was actually in fear for Holly's career at that time because I've been following her since her boxing days. So I thought, man, she's not going to come back from this. But Holly, the true warrior she is, she gets it together. She comes back and defeats Ann Sophie Mathis. But I'm saying the referee allowed her to take way too much punishment because she was the hometown fighter and they just want to give them a chance. It's like it is so hard for the referee to pull the plug on the hometown fighter. So maybe that's one of the reasons Mario did what he did. And I'm not trying to give him an excuse. I think he should have stopped the fight. But you know me, I'm just trying to get a brother a chance. I'm trying to say there had to be some reason he allowed that fight to go on that long. All right, guys, now it's your turn. Get into the comment section and let me know what you think about the aftermath of this fight. Are you mad at Valentina? Are you mad at Mario? Are you mad at Dana for even making the fight? That's another thing we can discuss on another video. Should the fight have been made? But I do want to say this. Valentina Shevchenko, woo! That lady can fight and is absolutely one of the top pound for pound fighters in the sport, man or woman. Okay, go through, check out some of the other videos. We will put a few in the description box. Until the next one, it's your boy Big E, aka Amazing Eric, with Amazing Eric Sports. I'm out, y'all. Peace.